Hello everyone, welcome back to part 21 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, I'm going to show you how to package your Endless Runner game for Android. Let's get started. First, open the Epic Games Launcher. In the Unreal Engine section, go to the library and find the version of Unreal Engine you're using for this project. Click the arrow next to the Launch button and select Options. In the Target Platforms, make sure Android is enabled. If it's not enabled, enable it and click Apply. This will update the engine. Next, we need to install some required software. You can find a document with all the requirements and their download links in the description. First, you have to install Visual Studio Community. While I have both 2019 and 2022 versions, installing 2022 will work fine. Make sure to include the following components while installing. .NET Desktop Development. Desktop development with C++, and game development with C++. Once Visual Studio and these components are installed, download and install Android Studio. If you're using Unreal Engine versions 5.1 or 5.2, install Android Studio 4.0. If you're using 5.3 or 5.4, install Android Studio Flamingo 2022. If you already have a different version of Android Studio, that should work too. You can find the mentioned versions in the Android Studio download archives. After installing Android Studio, you'll need to set up the SDKs and NDK. Open Android Studio and look for Configure or More Actions. If you have any projects open, you'll see three dots at the top. Click on them and select SDK Manager. In the SDK Manager, first make sure the SDK location is set to the default path. Then, go to the SDK Tools tab and enable Show Package Details at the bottom if it's not already enabled. For Android SDK Build Tools, select the following versions: 34.0, 32.0, 31.0, 30.0, 29.0, 28.0, 27.0, and 25.0. Scroll down to the NDK section and choose NDK 25.1.89. Scroll further to find Android SDK command line tools. If you're using Unreal Engine 5.1 or 5.2, select command line tools version 8.0. For Unreal Engine 5.3 or 5.4, choose the latest version. Click Apply to download and install these components. Once installed, verify the SDK and NDK locations. Now, let's install the JDK. For Unreal Engine 5.1 and 5.2, you need JDK 1.8.0_77. For Unreal Engine 5.3 and 5.4, install OpenJDK 1.7.0.6. You can find download links for these versions in the document linked in the description. After installation, you'll find the JDK files in C, Program Files, Java. With all the requirements installed, you need to set up environment variables. Press Windows plus S and search for environment variables. Open Edit the System Environment Variables and click on the Environment Variables button. In the new window, create a new user and system variables called java_home and set the value to the path of your JDK version, not JRE. After creating the variable, press OK and close the windows. Open your Unreal Engine project and go to Project Settings. Scroll down to Android SDK. If the SDK, NDK, and JDK paths are not already set, enter them manually. The default paths for the SDK, NDK, and JDK will be shown on the screen. After configuring the paths, return to the viewport, click on Platforms at the top, and select Refresh Platform Status. Wait a few seconds, and you should see the Android logo. If you don't see the logo, double-check your paths and the versions of the components you've installed. To adjust the packaging settings, go to Project Settings and select Packaging under Project. Expand Advanced and find List of Maps to include in a packaged build. Click the Add button and include the maps you want in the game. This is helpful if you have many maps that are unnecessary. Under Project, set the build configuration to Shipping. Choose the staging directory path where you want the packaged files to be saved. I recommend not enabling full rebuild for every package, but only when making significant changes to the game. Enable for distribution if you plan to release the game on stores like Google Play or itch.io. You can disable Include Prerequisites Installer as it's not crucial. Under Supported Platforms, disable any platforms you're not packaging for and only enable the ones you are targeting. Scroll down to find the Platforms section and click on Android. Select Configure Now. For the app package name, follow the reverse domain name notation. If you have a domain, like example.com, your package name could be com.example.appname. If you don't have a domain, you can use your GitHub username, such as com.github.username.appname. For the store version, set it to 1 when you first publish the game. Each time you update the game, increase the store version number, or the upload will fail. Set the minimum and target SDK versions based on your target devices. I'm setting the install location to auto. If you plan to publish on Google Play, enable App Bundles. This will create a .abb file that you can upload to Google Console during the publishing process. If you're publishing on app stores and have enabled for distribution, you must create a key store. I'll show you how to create one later in the video. In the icons section, you can add your game icons. Hover over the images to see their dimensions. To create the key store file, open the Java JDK folder, then the bin folder. Click on the address bar and type cmd to open command prompt. I've included a command to create a key store in the video description. Copy and paste it into command prompt. You can replace myalias and mykeystore with your preferred names. When prompted for a password, choose one and save it somewhere safe. Answer the questions as required. If asked for an alias password, press Enter to use the same password as the key store. You'll find the key store file in the JDK bin folder. Open your Unreal Engine project folder and navigate to Build, and then Android. Copy and paste the keystore file from the bin folder to the Android folder. In Unreal Engine project settings, enter the keystore name, in my case, mykeystore, and the keystore alias, in my case, myalias. For the keystore password, input the password you used when creating the keystore. If the keystore alias password is the same as the keystore password, leave it blank. Otherwise, enter the alias password. Go back to the viewport, click on Platforms, then Android, and select the texture compression format, ASTC, ETC2, or DXT. I recommend ETC2 as it's compatible with most devices, but ASTC is the latest format. Click on Package Project. The first time you package the project, it may take a while, depending on your system. So be patient. That's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via Discord. The details are in the description. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.